Welcome to Looking For. Today, I'm taking you to the land of the Ganges River and the Taj Mahal to tell you about an unusual monument, the tallest statue in the world. India's and Pakistan's independence was initiated by a growing unstable social climate and civil disobedience actions led by Gandhi. It was finally declared in 1947 after 89 years of British rule. Following this historic event, all 565 principalities of this vast territory had to decide whether to join India or Pakistan or to remain independent. This was a difficult task of unprecedented magnitude, and it was successfully handled by the Minister of Home Affairs at the time, Vallabhbhai Patel. This man is credited with the integration of all the princely kingdoms into contemporary India, but also recognized for his careful management of the crisis following Gandhi's assassination. He embodied unity in the eyes of the Indian people. 41 years after his death, the authorities decided to honor him with the Bharat Ratna, literally the jewel of India in Sanskrit, the highest civil decoration in the country. In 2013, Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India at the time, decided to raise a statue in Patel's honor. The Statue of Unity is located in the west of the country in Gujarat, Patel's home region. It is so massive that it almost seems unreal. The statue measures 182 meters high, which is equivalent to four Statues of Liberty stacked on top of each other. It is the biggest statue in the world by far, overtaking the previous title holders, the Temple of the Source Buddha in China and the Laykyun Setkyar statue in Burma. Its dimensions are even more impressive if you consider the size of its base, which raises the architectural height of the building to 240 meters. Imagine, if we place it in the middle of Paris, it would be higher than the Montparnasse Tower. The Statue of Unity was built by a branch of the Bombay-based L&T India Group. It was designed by Ram Sutta, a famous Indian sculptor, who was also asked to choose the pose of the future statue. He made several models of Patel to find the perfect pose. They were then modeled in three dimensions to allow engineers to decide which design would be the most feasible. The base of the structure was built to withstand the high mechanical stresses of the huge column. For the record, it weighs almost as much as the Eiffel Tower steel frame. The engineers also anticipated worst-case scenarios. They raised the foundation so that the statue's base would be protected from the water even if an exceptional flood occurred. The Statue of Unity was built on the bed of the Narmada River, a few miles downstream from the Sardar Sarovar Dam. The site's complex geomorphology required extensive preliminary studies to make sure that the statue would be safe and long-lasting. Although the statue is located on a rocky islet, it is very close to the riverbed. The island is therefore subject to strong natural stresses, in particular erosion, both caused by the water and the wind blowing into the valley. The 250 engineers who worked on the project also had to consider the seismic risk, as the Gujarat region is prone to it. They added two gigantic 200-ton balancing beams at the level of the statue's shoulders to counteract the lateral movements that the superstructure would undergo during a 6.5 magnitude earthquake. Finally, the statue is also designed to resist powerful winds, which can reach up to 111 miles per hour in the region. Yes, the engineers really thought of everything. The authorities decided to create a huge iron collection campaign to increase the symbolic dimension of the project. This campaign was a tribute to Patel, formerly known as the Iron Man. Farmers from all over the country contributed to the statue's construction by donating one or more iron farming tools. In total, 134 tons of material were collected, melted and mixed with 210,000 cubic meters of concrete, which was used for the building's foundations. Finally, 6,565 bronze plates cover the Statue of Unity, weighing in at 3,550 tons. By today's prices, that's $24 million, which is a significant amount considering the estimated $350 million budget for the building. The Statue of Unity was inaugurated on October 31st, 2018, after 4 years of work by close to 3,400 people. It has been a real success and attracts almost 15,000 visitors per day on average since its opening. The monument also has a panoramic viewing deck at the bust level, which can welcome up to 200 people at a time. There is also a museum dedicated to historical figures and agriculture. If you plan to visit this monument, you should know that you will have to travel 8 hours and a half by train to reach this place from Bombay, and pay $7 to access the panoramic deck. However, visiting the impressive Statue of Unity is worth the effort. Alright, that's it for today. I hope you like this topic on great monuments. If so, feel free to let me know in the comments which monument you would like to see next time. Thanks for watching and see you soon on Looking For. Goodbye!